Want to know how to manifest your greatest goals and dreams? Who doesn't? Want to do it with a highly intelligent, effective, and proven system like the chakras? In today's video, I'll cover the chakra manifestation process. What happens at each of the seven steps? And the first things you need to do to start a successful manifestation journey. If you haven't joined our yoga fam yet, click that subscribe button and bell to be notified every time I post a new video helping you to practice yoga on and off your mat, which is something I truly believe in, taking your yoga on the mat, off the mat to support your daily life. Now, I've taught these same manifestation concepts at our sold out chakra yoga retreats and also inside the Body Mind Soul Studio that houses an entire chakra manifestation program, as well as several mini courses on the topic. Women who've chosen to go on this journey with me have manifested new businesses, career changes, getting out of debt, becoming sober, healing, creating or leaving relationships, changing locations, moving to entirely different countries or states, long-term travel, and more. I've also used it on myself. So let me know in the comments if you've got a dream you want to manifest and work towards, and what is that dream? It's always so fun to see our unique desires as well as what we share in common. You'd be surprised by just how many of us are seeking very similar things. So what is the manifestation process anyway? Well, let me give you the 411, but from the chakra perspective, because there's a lot of manifestation systems out there, methodologies, but I am trained in the chakra system, so you're gonna always hear about that from me. So generally the chakras are taught as a system that goes from root to crown, or what's known as the liberation current. A little bit about this current. It is liberating us from attachments and limitations by moving away from lower chakra activity, having, feeling, and doing, and towards the upper chakra experiences of connecting, creating, visualizing, and knowing. When you're working from the bottom up, the goals are freedom, liberation, expansion, universality, and transcendent consciousness. Now, this is the most common way that people work with the chakra system from root to crown. Many yoga philosophies, psychologies, Eastern traditions, and religions are also based on this ascension model, or disconnecting from material possessions and becoming less and less attached to the physical body and our earth plane reality. This is a beautiful journey to travel, but we as human beings have to live here on this earth plane in this reality, right? So to balance the liberation current, we have what's called the manifestation current. And this current travels from the crown down to the root. And it's bringing us towards reality by condensing the upper chakra realms of dreaming, visualizing, speaking, and connecting towards lower chakra creating or doing, feeling, and having. Those are all the activities of chakras that I'm listing out, by the way. And when working from the top down, the goal really is enjoyment, individuality, tangible results, and cognitive consciousness. Now, it's really important to note that neither current is better than the other, and both of them will help you clear blockages, restore balance, and create body, mind, soul alignment. Like I said, both are valiant journeys to travel. Often when working with the manifestation current, you'll simultaneously be developing and healing the chakras just as you would if you were working with the traditional liberation current going from root to crown. So don't think that, oh, I'm missing out on something if I want to go in this direction instead. Now, if you're brand new to chakra manifestation and this is the first time you're hearing about it, check out these yoga classes to experience it on the mat, or this video here where I introduce you to the chakra system at large. Really important so you have a base understanding of what we're working with here. Once you have that base understanding, and also you're like, okay, I'm tracking with you, Allie, about the two currents and the liberation, the manifestation that we both just touched on, we want to dive into the seven chakras and the key steps revolving around manifestation. So step one begins with the crown chakra, Sahasrara, located here at the top of the head. And when we're working with the very first step, we want to connect with these universal higher realms of consciousness and pull them down into our individual galaxy of thinking and awareness. How do we do that? The primary work here is to create internal spaciousness through becoming aware of your limiting beliefs and rewiring or reprogramming them, and also developing a meditation practice. Meditation is the sole recommendation for the crown chakra. When we do this, we uncover and replace limiting beliefs, all right? We gain access to new ideas, inspiration, and insight. We receive answers to difficult questions, and we develop a greater understanding of self, capital S, and also this all-pervading knowing that I'm okay. I'm supported. The universe has my back regarding this dream I'm wanting to pursue, this journey I'm wanting to go on. That's step one. Step two brings us to the third eye chakra, Ajna, where you learn to believe in your vision and choose a dream. This is your right to see. So you want to turn your vision inward and discover how you want your life to look, feel, and be. This is the step where you develop your inner vision, you trust your intuition, you connect with your imagination, and you choose a dream to bring down into reality, which is the root chakra. And by the way, you gotta choose one dream and only one dream to work on at a time, which can be really difficult. Step three brings us to the throat chakra, Vishuddha, where you'll speak your truth. Now that you've chosen a dream, you gotta get it out of your head and into the world. This is the first step that includes others, which can be incredibly terrifying. The work here is to communicate your dream effectively. Practice sharing your story because everyone's story is unique and it matters. You also want to open yourself up to feedback from trusted sources so you can refine that communication, and you'll set your first goals here too. It's also here where you really want to listen inwardly to any subtle or internal messages that you're receiving regarding your chosen dream. Because remember, we're now speaking it out into the world, so we also want to stay anchored in our own communication that's happening. Step four brings us to the heart chakra, Anahata, where we trust our desires and co-create with others. The primary work here is to ask yourself, what are my heart's desires? What do I love about this chosen dream? And how can I be of service while living my purpose? Now, when we lead with the heart versus the ego, which by the way is the next chakra, your actions will create an enjoyable, long-lasting manifestation experience or something that's sustainable. We're always wanting to move towards that, right? We want to think long-term here. The heart chakra is your social identity. So it's here that relationships really begin to matter when you're working towards your dream. You want to identify, whose help do I need? How do I create a supportive dream team? Who are those people I want to support me? And continue to ask the question, how can my dream be of service to humanity? Step five brings us to the solar plexus chakra, Manipura. The element is fire. And here we're going to take imperfect and also aligned action. With love leading the way from step four, your dream can now enter the active phase of manifestation. Your work here is to command your personal power, strengthen your will, be proactive versus passive, plan each step to the earth plane, take that imperfect action, and burn through obstacles with grace and ease. I want to warn you though, this step can be one of the most challenging ones in the process because now we're moving into that active phase and many will abandon their dream here. Step six brings us to the sacral chakra, Svadhisthana, the element's water. So it's here that we want to release resistance and flow downstream towards our dreams. Or in simpler terms, we want to remain flexible and fluid with the many changes, challenges, and obstacles that will undoubtedly arise as we continue to create our dream. No dream journey is perfect and no dream journey follows any specific methodology without changes becoming part of the process. Your work here is also to honor your needs and really believe in them and receive nourishment. Have fun. Think of fun as the grease to your dream machine. And you want to approach this entire journey with playfulness so you don't burn out, fatigue, or begin to resent your dream, which has totally happened to me. And lastly, step seven brings us to the root chakra, Muladhara, or the earth plane. The final step is to believe in your right to have this dream that you've worked so hard for. Don't self-sabotage sabotage. You also need to fulfill your commitments, complete what you began, take care of your physical health and well-being. This is your physical identity. Your body's got to be in great condition to be able to enjoy this dream. You also need to tend to practical things like finances. And finally, rest, reflect, and celebrate, because all that's happened on this journey is incredible. And you also want to be able to continue to create within this now, here, here, now dream. Whew! The manifestation journey is complete. I've personally used this process for many of my own dreams and continue to use it as a reference and a guide and a compass with my greater life visions and the individual dreams I'm manifesting. And now that you know the steps, how does one get started? Because that was a lot of information. The last thing we'll cover today here are practical, effective tools to begin creating your dreams using the chakra system. First, invest in the book Creating on Purpose by Anna Dea Judith. This book and her workshop that I took in person are what has informed everything I shared here today, as well as the chakra manifestation courses and retreats that I lead. The link to purchase this book is in the description below. Again, I can't recommend it enough. It's going to really give you everything I just shared, but way more in depth. Second, commit to starting and sustaining a meditation practice. Remember, this was the tool from step one, crown chakra, and it's how the entire process begins. We can't even choose a dream if the mind is on overdrive, thinking about or ruminating about all the things, right? So often people come to me and they say, I don't even have a dream, Allie. So you gotta start here. If you need a short meditation practice, I recommend this one and doing it for 40 days straight. You got this. I believe in you. Thirdly, and finally, give yourself permission to ask this incredibly important and powerful question. How do I want my life to look and feel? This question will begin to turn on your imagination and get the wheels spinning. No pun intended, the chakras are wheels. And once you get them spinning and online, you can then start to arrive at, what is my dream? Now, like I said, many struggle with what to pursue because they bypass these critical steps, creating internal spaciousness and allowing themselves to be very lucid and dream big, all right? By removing the logical thought of how will I do this? How could it ever happen? And instead only focusing on the what, we'll get closer to our most aligned dream. All right, yoga fam, we have arrived at the earth plane. Quick journey, I know. To continue learning with me, download my yoga reset guide, a 7-step journey through the chakra system to recenter your body, mind, and soul. The guide includes on the mat classes, energy aligning exercises, chakra mantras and affirmations that I love working with, and self-reflection journal prompts. It's an approachable way to begin working with the chakras today. Details to download the yoga reset guide are in the description below of this video. I hope you have it waiting in your inbox shortly after we finish here. Now, if you enjoyed this off the mat lesson, give this video a like, share what you learned today in the comments. Actually typing out what you learned and participating is a way for you to remember what we've spoken about here today. And finally, join our yoga fam by hitting that subscribe button. Thank you for being here. And as always, now the real work begins, right? Taking your yoga off the mat, off the cushion, off the screen, and into your daily life so you can manifest your dreams.